Hello students, let us start a new chapter, Data Visualization using PyPlot. This chapter deals with how to represent information and data using visual elements such as graph, map, chart, etc. You can see data visualization can be defined as the graphical or visual representation of information and data using visual elements like charts, graphs, maps, etc. Data visualization in Python can be done using many packages such as matplotlib. You must have drawn and seen in your previous classes like 9th and 10th, and in 10th class you must have drawn a graph in terms of x-axis and y-axis. You can see these examples. The first example is, you can see the line graph. This is the line graph. Okay, this is x-axis, y-axis. Okay, so we have some values for x-axis, some values for y-axis, and in this way this line graph has been drawn. Similarly, x and y-axis coordinates can be represented using bar graph also. This is bar graph. Similarly, in terms of pie chart also, these can be represented. Okay, so in this way, what is data visualization? Okay, this is nothing but the representation of data in terms of graph, charts and bars. Now, what is required? We will see in this chapter what is required in Python in order to draw these graphs and charts. First thing which is required is the library matplotlib and the interface pyplot which resides in this library. How can you define matplotlib? It is a robust, free and easy 2D plotting library that helps in visualizing figures by using Python scripts. So in Python scripts we will be using which module? Matplotlib module. Actually, this is the library having many other modules and interfaces. Now, out of different many interfaces, we have to use PyPlot. Mind you, PyPlot. PyPlot is an interface of matplotlib which has the collection of methods such as plot, bar, py, legend, x-axis, y-axis, etc. to create the desired plot. For example, if we need to draw plot, means line graph, then we'll be using plot function. If we need to draw bar chart, then we will need to use this bar function. Similarly, in case of pie chart, we'll be using pie function, etc. So these are the different functions which are the part of PyPlot interface, which resides in which module? In module matplotlib. Now matplotlib offers several types of plots as follows: line graph, we can draw lines, bar graph, pie chart, we can also draw the histogram, area plot, scatter plot. In the further screens you will be seeing how to draw histogram, area plot, scatter plot, etc. Now let us clear about, let us be clear about the various functions and what does this function do. First function is plot, which is used to draw line graph, bar, which is used to draw bar graph, pie, it is used to draw pie chart. Similarly, if you have to label the x-axis, then x label, y label to label y-axis, show, it display the graph. Students, there are two things. One is these functions plot, bar and pie, then we have show function. You see, plot, bar and pie function, they are used to draw line graph, bar chart or pie chart, but they, by using these functions, these bars or line graph, they cannot be displayed on the screen. In order to display these graphs, we have to use show functions, right? So once we call plot function, then ultimately eventually we will have to call show function so that these line graphs or pie chart can be displayed onto the monitor. And if you want to save that chart which you have displayed onto the monitor, you can save that figure also by calling this function, the save figure. It saves the figure. Similarly, legend, you must have seen in a line graph or in a pie chart, in any type of graph or chart, there is a label, a box of label inside the graph. So that label for the graph can be displayed or can be drawn by using legend function. We can also set the limit for x-axis, the maximum limit, by xlim. Similarly, we can set the limit for y-axis, means the maximum value, by using ylim. Similarly, we can display various values for the various x or y coordinates or labels by using this x sticks and y sticks, you can see. So in further examples, we'll be using these functions. Now, before actually drawing the line graph or other graphs, let us find out and let me explain all the attributes of this function. Firstly, plot function. Plot function has all these important attributes. One is the color, okay, which provide color to the graph or line graph. Line width, the width of the line graph. Line style, what will be the style of line, whether it will be a plain line or dotted line or dashed line. Okay, if you don't put any line style, then by default it will be a normal line without any dot or dashed. But if you mention line style is equal to dotted or dashed, then line will look like that. Similarly, marker. Marker means the point on the line graph. So the point means the x and y coordinate, that point. So that point can also be defined by marker. So in marker, you can provide the marker style, what kind of marker style can be displayed. Then marker edge color, you can define color for that marker. So these are the different and important attributes of plot function. We'll be using these attributes while drawing the line graph. Similarly, while using bar function, these are the important function: height, width and bottom. Height means it represents height of the bar, width represent width of the bar, bottom provides the y coordinate to the bar. Similarly, these are the important attributes of pie function. Okay, so the first attribute is x. X means it is the array of values on the basis of which wedges of the pie chart will be displayed or will be drawn. Then we have explode function attribute. Okay, explode, it is defined or it is used for the offset for each and every wedge. So we can define the offset of the wedge. Then label, okay, for each wedge we can define the label, color, auto percentage. So these are the different attributes which will be clear in the example. When we will explain, we will see the example of pie function. This is the first example. You can see the first example is of line graph. You can see the graph. What is required in order to draw a line graph? We require x-axis, values of x-axis, this is the x-axis, okay, and values of y-axis. This is y-axis and this is x-axis. Firstly, first statement is import matplotlib. This is the library In this library, there is an interface pyplot. So we need to import only pyplot, not all the interfaces. As plt, okay, this is the alias name for the matplotlib.pyplot. So we'll be using plt in place of matplotlib.pyplot. So this is very important. In all the data visualization program, we have to import this interface. Then here, this is the x-axis, 2014, 2015, 16, 17, 18, 19. So these values you can see here on the x-axis. Similarly, tutorial count, okay, these values are of y-axis. You can see the number of tutorial count. Okay, so these values, this is the y-axis. Now, what is required? We need to invoke this function, plot function. Okay, so for line graph, we have to use plot function. For bar chart, we have to use bar function. For pie chart, we have to use pie function, and so on. So since we have to draw the line graph, so we have used plot function. So let us invoke this function, plt.plot. What is required? X-axis, then y-axis. That's all. Apart from these two, x-axis and y-axis, we can also give other attributes also, color, line style, etc., line width, etc. Okay, so these attributes can be given. Okay, but in this example, I have given just x-axis and y-axis in the form of year and tutorial count. Then plt.xlabel. Now this is the label of x-axis, year. This is the label. Okay, so this label can be defined by using x label, then y label. These are the function for labeling x axis and y axis. So in order to label y axis, we have used this y label. Y label, number of Visual Studio IO. You can see number of Visual Studio IO tutorials. Okay, so this is the y axis label. Then you can see plt.show. This function is very important. Otherwise, your line graph cannot be displayed onto the monitor. So plot is to draw the line graph, but show is to display the line graph onto the monitor. So show is very, very important. That's all. So if you execute this set of instructions, you will get this kind of line graph. So it is very easy to understand and to practice also. Next, you can see there are two line graphs in the same graph, right? Now, two line graphs, how can we plot multiple line graphs? Okay, very simple. You need to define or invoke the plot function two times. Here we have invoked this plot function, here also and here also. Okay, but before invoking these functions, we have defined x-axis and y-axis. You can see the x-axis is same, year. Okay, and there are two y-axis, tutorial public and tutorial premium. Okay, so the other two y-axis. So firstly, I have plotted plt.plot year versus tutorial public. Now here we have given this two attributes, color, this is the color code, and this is line width, 3. Okay, 3 pixel. Then I have plotted another line graph, plt.plot year versus tutorial premium. Okay, so here y-axis is different, y-axis is tutorial premium. Here also color is different, you can see a different color code, okay, which is yellow, and this color code, it stands for violet. Okay, here also line width is 3. So in this way, we have plotted two line graph. Now we have labeled the x-axis by using xlabel function, year. So this is the label. And then we have labeled y-axis by calling ylabel function, number of Future Studio IO tutorials. You can see this label. and then we have displayed, okay, this line graph by using show function. Okay, so in this way you can draw multiple line graphs. Let us move on to the pie chart. What is pie chart? A pie graph or pie chart is a specialized graph used in statistics. The independent variable is plotted around a circle. You see, in pie chart we use only one variable, right? Because the values of that variable will be depicted as the percentage of each and every value out of the 100, okay, or out of the whole. So we have to use only one variable, unlike line graph. Okay, in line graph we have to have the values for x-axis and y-axis, but here we need only one variable. Pie chart shows proportions and percentages between categories by dividing a circle into proportional segment or parts. So the whole circle is divided into the proportions or segments in terms of the various values of a variable. Now in the pie chart, the whole pie chart, the whole circle is segmented into various arcs, and each arc length represents a proportion of each category, while the full circle represents the total sum of all the data equal to 100. So 100% means the full circle. You can see this is the circle, the full circle is 100%. Okay, and these are the various values of the variable. Okay, so how many variables are there? Variable is 2, but in that variable there are 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 values in that variable. You can see the first statement is we have imported matplotlib.pyplot. Okay, and alias name is plt. Now the variable is slices, and we have 4 values, 7, 2, 2 and 13. And then activities, this is the labels for these different arcs. Labels are sleeping, eating, working, playing, and this is the color code CMRB. This is the color code, R for red, B for blue, M for magenta, C for cyan. Okay, so these are the color codes. Now how to plot the pie chart? plt.py, this is the function using which we can draw the pie chart. Now what is required? Slices. This variable is required. Okay, you can see slices, then labels, activities, colors, COLS, start angle 9, shadow true, explode, auto percentage. So these are the various attributes. So the most important attribute is slices. Okay, so this variable is needed, okay, because this variable contains these 4 values, 7, 2, 2, 13. So automatically these values will be converted into respective percentage out of 100, right? So you can find out the percentage for 7, 2, 2 and 13, and this percentage will automatically be displayed here. For example, sleeping, okay, the value for sleeping is 7. Okay, so automatically the pie plot will convert this 7 into its percentage, 29.2%. okay, and similarly eating, the value for eating is 2, so this has been converted into, second is this 8.3%, magenta 8.3, eating, and then working 8.3%. okay, so you can see these two wedges, okay, their sizes are equal because percentage is equal. Okay, and 13 is the highest value. Okay, so automatically 13 will be converted for playing to 54.2%. okay, so you can see the largest wedge. Okay, so students, different parts of the pie chart, they are called wedges. So wedges playing, wedge working, wedge eating and wedge sleeping. So in this way there are 4 wedges. Okay, based on the four values of slices. So these are the slices, labels, activities. In activities, there are four labels. So we have to give the number of labels according to the number of values in the variable. Okay, so since there are four values, so there are four labels activities. So these are the labels: sleeping, eating, working, playing. So automatically these activities will be attached with the wedges. Okay, so slices, labels, then colors. Automatically there are four colors because there are four activities, so four colors. So automatically colors will also be attached to the four wedges, right? Then the start angle 90 degrees. So this is the first wedge, start angle is 90. Okay, explode means the offset. There are four values of 0 0.1 0 0. So 0.1 means second wedge. Second wedge means eating. You can see the eating, the wedge of eating is just coming out from the center. Okay, so the fraction of the offset is 0.1. okay, so this is 1 out of 10. Okay, so this is the 10%. So 10% will be exploded out. Okay, so this, it defines the offset of the wedge. So explode defines the offset. Okay, then we can give the title to the whole plot, pie plot. Okay, pie chart, interesting graph, check it out. Interesting graph, check it out. To the next line, slash n, next line. Now finally we have invoked the show function. So this is very important. Until you invoke this show function, the pie chart will not be displayed. Okay, so in this way you can define and draw your pie chart and display the pie chart, right? So this is very easy and very easy to understand. Now the last thing I would explain is the bar chart in this video tutorial. You can see the bar chart, you must have seen in the previous classes. Okay, this is how we can draw the bar chart. What is bar chart? A bar chart or bar graph is a chart or graph that represents categorical data with rectangular bars with heights or lengths proportional to the values that they represent. So height or length of these bars, okay, they will be proportional to the given values, given set of values. The bars can be plotted vertically or horizontally. Okay, here also the first statement is we have imported the pie plot but in a different way. From matplotlib, import pyplot as PLT. Okay, so this is also one way of importing pyplot interface. The alias name is PLT. Now x-axis we have defined is 583, y-axis 12 16 6. X2, there are actually two bar graphs, x2 6 9 11, y2 this. Okay, so first bar we have plotted x versus y, align center. Second bar we have plotted x2 versus y2, its color is green, align is center. Okay, and for the first bar, okay, there is the by default color blue, and then we have used PLT title to give the title to this bar graph, epic info. You can see the title. Then we have labeled y-axis, y-label, labeled x-axis by using x-label. Okay, so they are the label, y-axis and x-axis. Okay, then finally we have invoked the show function. So this is also very easy to draw a bar graph or bar chart. Students, in the next tutorial, I'll be explaining two or three more topics in data visualization. So the most important thing is the first statement in any program concerned with the data visualization. The first statement is they import matplotlib.pyplot, right? Or you can import it like from matplotlib import pyplot. So until you import this interface pyplot, you cannot use bar, plot or py functions or xlabel, ylabel. So these functions are defined within interface pyplot. So this is very, very important to import this interface. Other things are quite easy, because either you define a line graph or bar graph or pi graph. Okay, what you need is the x coordinates and y coordinates. Okay, only in pie chart you need only one variable having multiple values, but in bar chart or line graph you require the values for x-axis and values for y-axis. Okay, and just by passing x and y-axis you can draw either bar graph or line graph. Thank you, students.